Morning, guys. So it is day 7 of Vlogmas. We just got back from the gym. We did upper body instead of spin. It was our first time actually using the normal gym because we changed gyms a little while ago, like a few months ago. So we were a bit nervous to try the normal gym. So we usually just do spin every day. But there isn't any spin on the weekends and I like to go every day. So we went and did upper body. It was actually fine, like we did really well, so that's really good. So we're gonna try and go maybe like 2-3 times a week and do that as well as spin. And then we also went for a dog walk afterwards. I'll insert some clips from that. But yeah, and then now I'm just having some breakfast, so I'll turn you around and show you what I'm having.
It doesn't look that pretty. It never does, but I've got some leftover hula hoops from last night. They seem to want to spread, so it makes it look like there's so much more than there is. And then we have a cheese and tomato omelette because I need the protein after going to the gym. So yes, I'm gonna eat this, and I've also got a cup of tea.
Right, so we're going to open our calendars just before I pop to the post office. That brownie that I decorated, I have just packaged it. I'll show you it all packaged. I haven't actually like sealed it yet. We are on day 7. I'm just opening Cleo's first. So we have, I think these are beef fillets. So she's on the sofa, I'll show you, because you can't really see her. There you go. It's really dark in here. I found that like these winter mornings, even though my room has a massive bay window, it's so dark. Oh, it's just started raining as well. That's so annoying. I'm gonna have to change my shoes. I was gonna go out in my slippers. They look like Uggs, but they're slippers, but they're not good in rain. So we'll have to change them. Right, I think I got, oh no, I chopped it on the floor. 5 second rule, I think. It's a little Christmas tree, that's what we got today. And then, see what hot chocolate we're gonna make when we get back. So, this box isn't very good, as you can see. It's all like breaking and everything because it's not the best layout. Ooh, we got a new one today. It is French vanilla. See what that's like. So we'll have that when we get back because I will probably be freezing now that it's raining. So I am going to finish packing up this brownie order now. Right, so we're going to package up our half and half slab. So I start with a cellophane bag. Make sure that the chocolate is all set. So as you can see, that's all set because I left it in the fridge. Otherwise, it will just smudge all over. Fold that over. Get any air out of there.
And then we are going to wrap the tray. Then we're going to put our little message in. You can't really see it on the camera, but it's just a little thank you note. And that's the back of it. Business card. Then we have allergens and storage information in there. Then we are just going to fill the gap at the front. Tuck that in. And as you can see, it's not moving at all. Then we are going to put sticker on the top. So once you've packaged that up, tuck any excess in. I've got little resealable stickies here, so I'm just going to peel that off, fold it round like so. Then we're going to put it in our mailing bag. And then I have these. I usually get smaller ones, but I got ones that were too big. These are, I believe, A5. So what I do is cut them in half so that it either says documents or enclosed, so that it makes some kind of sense rather than the whole thing, just so that they're not wasted, because they won't physically like fit. That's too big to go on the box. So this way you get to use either side. So, and then I have a little fragile label, and then we have our printed label. So you're just going to slide that in there, and then because you cut it in half, you just have to sellotape up the side so that it doesn't come out. And then I just have a little perishable sticker which I stick on the front, trying to make sure I cover, but yeah, so that it looks like that. Right, so a little bit of a change of plan, but I decided that I was going to make a gift guide. That's what I've been doing for the past hour or so. So I've got a load of stuff in my basket, and I thought that I'd make a little baker's gift guide. So some of these stores are places that I really like to buy from. So there's two main ones, three main ones actually. Then there's a couple others that you'll know about, and then we have our trusty Amazon, which we love. So I am going to put my computer on record, and then I will show you my screen. I've got, like I say, various things in my basket, so you can just search them up by name on the websites. I will link all the websites down below, and yeah, you should be able to search everything, but if you need links, let me know. But you should literally be able to copy the name, because you'll be able to see it in my basket. So right, so firstly we have let's go to continue shopping. So we have Lizzie Lou London. So this is a place which I found at the Cake and Bake Show, and there's this one, and then there's also Bake Box Boutique. They are both very similar in terms of what they sell. However, there are certain things which I think are better in each store. So some, they both have embossers. Lizzie Lou has the Alpha Bakes, which is the stamp letters and also stencils. But there are some embossers that I prefer on Bake Box Boutique. That's a real tongue twister. So we're gonna go through my basket on Lizzie Lou. So firstly, we have this stencil, which you can see, absolutely gorgeous. It's a very popular design. It's slightly different to the ones that I've seen. It's a little less cluttered. Usually these fans are a little closer together, but I think that this is a lot nicer. Typically people don't do it all the way around the cake. They do it maybe on like two corners of the cake, so this would be really nice just to give effect. And some people do it in a similar color to the base rather than a high contrast color, and then it adds a really nice effect. So these are £18. I believe when I was at the show they were slightly cheaper. I don't remember them being that much, but I mean, who knows, they could have been that much. But they are well worth it. They're something that you can use really regularly. There's plenty of people that I see that use them in like most of their cakes. I don't typically use stencils, but I think that's because I've only just got into them, so people don't necessarily know that I offer them, but I do really like the effect they give. So the next thing is some stamps and embossers. So I've put some of my favorites in the basket because I think it just gives you an idea, but there are hundreds, which I will show you in a second. This one I absolutely love. It's a little cocktail and it says party. This is partly like a little wish list for myself, if I'm completely honest. But it also works for you guys. So then we have this one, which is Happy Mother's Day. I thought this was really nice because it's not just a typical wordy stamp. Like, it's also got the detail on it. So that's that one. The stamps are £5. The embossers are, I think, £8 roughly. Some are £7.50 and some are more than that. But most of them are like £7-8, but the stamps are definitely cheaper. Then we have a bride-to-be stamp. It's kind of a universal one. It's really good to have. I feel like things like happy birthday, thank you, congrats, baby shower, or like oh baby, and then bride-to-be ones are ones that are pretty standard. It means that if you don't want to buy hundreds, because I mean, I could buy all of these, but it just wouldn't be good for me, then it means that you can have some like staple items. So as you can see, there's bride to be, there's bride tribe, so there's various different designs. Then another one that I really like, which is perfect for Valentine's Day but also can just be used all year round, is this little I love you one, and then you can paint where it's embossed. Really, really pretty. Then we have this floral heart, and these are really good because you can use them with these like kind of border style ones. There's various circle ones, there's hearts, there's little hexagons and stuff with little flowers on the side, a bit like this. And what you can use them for is you can put names in the middle. So I've seen where people have stamped initials or a whole name in the center, and then it just adds a really nice effect. So it can be like a custom item in the box if it's a treat box for someone's birthday or something like that. So those are the embossers and cookies that I would like go for. But I will give you a little show, just a general run through, because there are, like I say, hundreds. But as you can see, you can get embossers and stamps, and then you can get the matching cookie cutter, and these are gorgeous. I mean, that one's lovely. I'm really getting into like sugar cookies because I just love them when they have the fondant on top. I'm really trying to start including them in things. All these Mr. and Mrs. are lovely. These thank you ones where you can then cut out. This is what I was on about, where it's like squares, or this one is like a notice board, and then you can stamp people's initials or names if it's for like a wedding. Then these are perfect for weddings but also for babies. So there's like calendar ones. So this one just shows January, and then what you can do is do a little X on the day of the month. So those are really, really cool. So as you can see, there's so many. It just goes on and on. these are what the cookie cutters look like on their own. Bridesmaid, so pretty. I saw that one when I was there and I was like, I really want that one. So as you can see, there are loads on here. Then we also have Bait Box Boutique, which will also be good for those things. So I wanted to recommend some scrapers because these looked really good when I went to the show because I saw them in person, and they are very similar to the Finch Bakery ones. However, they are double-sided, which is the difference. So they have two patterns on each scraper, whereas the Finch Bakery ones only have one. So this one is a staple one. It's a double-edged stripe. It has a small stripe and a medium stripe, which I have both from Finch Bakery, separate scrapers, and they are both thoroughly used. Then we have another one which is very well used, and that is a scallop scraper. So these are £15. I think the Finch Bakery ones are £12, but that's only one design, whereas this is two. So I thought that these were pretty good. That's why I thought I'd share. So then we have this one, which is the inverted scallop, and then the, like, whatever the opposite of that is, like, outverted. I don't know what the word is, but where it's like a bubble. So you have both on there. So I thought that they were definitely a staple. Then we have the Alpha Bakes fonts. I really like, they do 5 or 6 different fonts. I really like this particular one. So as you can see, this is what it looks like. It's font number 5. And this is large, so you can see how big it is on the fondant. And then that's the numbers, that's medium. That's also medium, but that's lowercase. I would like, this is just personal preference, I think that the, unless you want to buy both sets, which you may be able to afford that, but they're £21 a set. So I would recommend the uppercase, because you can write words in fully uppercase and they look fine. However, you can't, or I think it would look unusual, if you did full words, so say like Amy, if you did that in all lowercase, because the A should really be a capital letter. So I think it's better to go for the uppercase set if you have to pick one, because you can write words and names and like phrases like happy birthday and all of that. You can write that all in uppercase and it looks fine. But I think if you write things in all lowercase, it won't give a very good effect and it won't really make sense. So yeah, like I say, if you're trying to save money or you want just one set and you have to pick one, then I'd recommend the uppercase, I think. So you have to buy, unless you buy like a big set, I believe you have to buy the bar on its own. I know the uppercase font doesn't have the bar included, and the bar is £10 and it looks like so. So make sure that if anyone does decide to buy this for you, they buy the bar, because otherwise you're, I mean, you can use it, but you're not, your letters aren't necessarily going to be in line, so you'd have to individually stamp different numbers and letters in there. So that's everything for Lizzie Lou. As you can see, I'll do a quick once over, but they have merchandise, they have a whole Christmas section, but that will be kind of over soon in terms of sprinkles and stuff like that. They have a sprinkle section, which I saw these at the show and they actually look really good. Their mixes, as you can see, are so colourful. This one, the unicorn one, lovely. Saw that in person, and that green is really pretty. Then there was another one. Is it one of these at the top? That one. This white and gold, again, lovely mix. That red is really nice in the Christmas cheer one, but that's actually in the sale, I assume, because Christmas is coming up. So they do various things. Then they have all the letters, embossers, stamps, scrapers, stencils. They actually sell cakesicle sticks as well, and acrylic cake boards. But I have never used acrylic cake boards. Some people use them if they do a lot of fondant, because then it means that you can decorate it on the acrylic board and then move it. But I typically decorate mine on the board that it's staying on. So that's Lizzie Lou. Then we have Bake Box Boutique, which I've had an order from them recently. I really, really like them. I bought stuff from Lizzie Lou at the show, but then since then I've been buying from Bake Box Boutique. I also got some sprinkles from there, which were really nice. So these are my absolute faves. These are definitely on my wish list. So you should be able to see it without me clicking on them because the pictures are a bit bigger than on Lizzie Lou. I can actually zoom in. There we go. So we have Let's Party. And these are similar price, so the embossers are £8. I haven't got any stamps in here, but I believe the stamps are £6, so they're slightly more. But I think that they do different things well. So, like, Lizzie Lou, I really like all their wedding ones and all their baby ones, but this company has really good other ones, so like birthdays and like just celebrations in general. So like this Let's Party one I absolutely love because it's got the little disco ball and the cocktail, looks really nice. Then we have these champagne glasses, which is another one that I really like. Then we have this heart embosser. So these are really good for either if you want to emboss say you have a cookie, and the same with these animal ones, which I've seen on various like accounts that use these embossers from this site. So they do this heart base where they emboss it, and then they cut out another layer of fondant and stick it on top, so the heart acts as like a background, and then you can add another layer of fondant on top of that, and then it gives that raised effect, and you can then stamp a name or like I love you if you're doing Valentine's, anything like that into it. So I really like the effect that they give, because then it means that you can kind of layer with fondant on your sugar cookies, which I think is a good idea. I've never seen that done apart from like these embossers I've seen, but that style where you layer two bits of fondant and one is like a background of say leopard print, and then the top layer is just plain white and it's got words embossed in it. I think it's quite a cool idea, so that's why I added them, because I was like they will be good for that. Then we have this pretty candles, which I love. Perfect for birthdays if you're doing like a treat box and you want to either do it on cupcakes or you can do it on sugar cookies. Then we have this Dalmatian, which is my favourite out of the animal prints, just because I love leopard print, but I think Dalmatian is kind of like timeless. So you know how like leopard print goes out of fashion occasionally? This is something that I feel like will never go out of fashion. Like Dalmatian is just cute. So the last thing is these ultra fine precision brushes. There were loads of brushes at the Cake and Bake show. I did not know how to pick them, honestly, and this might be a more expensive set, but I don't necessarily know what the quality of like places that are just like on Amazon or eBay or whatever, I don't know what the quality would be like, whereas these have good reviews and I saw them in person and I almost bought them. So I think that they're a good bet if you're looking for some precision brushes. So these are for when you're painting your embossed fondant. So because it's embossed, it means that if you make any mistakes when you're painting, it's really, really difficult to get that off because it's paint. So it means that you can wipe it off, but if it has any sort of glitter in it, a bit like if you're doing gold or silver, you almost can't get it off. I've had that issue before, and then you usually have to redo that bit of fondant. So these are really good because they are very, very thin and they're pointed. So it means that you can get a bit of paint on the point and then gently get that on your brush. Whereas I actually have flat ones currently and it makes it very, very difficult to paint. It takes me about half an hour and it shouldn't take me that long. So yeah, they are a pain. So these are a really good investment. They're £14 for free, but I think that they're something that would be really useful. So that's everything on Bake Box Boutique. I'll just quickly give you a little show around. So they have some molds on here. They have various cookie cutters. This is what I was on about. This I love you. So as you can see, they've used the hearts in the background and they've used the I love you on top. They do sprinkles. They sell Colour Mill. Their sprinkle sets are really pretty. This pink, gold, black and white gives me like 18th or 21st vibes. And it's just, I love it. Sprinkle filled baubles, which are something that you can obviously buy for Christmas as a gift. definitely something to add to the gift guide, and it just means that you can either store your sprinkles in there once you run out, and it just makes it seem Christmassier. So then we have all these mixes. This is the one that I got, the Princess Winter Wonderland. Love that mix. That's what I got for my Christmas boxes. So a lot of these are Christmas ones. Then we get on to all the Valentine's ones, which I'm holding off for the moment because I already have so many sprinkles, but I'm definitely tempted. And this mix, I saw this before. So there's the nude sprinkle box, gorgeous, and then there is the Lulu Luxe, which it's just the perfect mix of nudes. And again, this baby bear. That's what I like about their sprinkle mixes. They have a lot of like nudes and neutral colours. So they might still be pinks, but the tones are so nice, and like pinks and blues, browns, mustardy colours, so, so nice. And they also go with the new colour mill so well, which I actually have a couple added to my cake decorating company order, because that's typically where I get my colour mill from. But Bake Box Boutique, I feel like I can't say it. I also got some colour mill from them recently, with my sprinkles. So they all do. There's quite a few places that do colour mill. I usually just depend on where I'm buying stuff, and then you save on postage. So the next place is Seriously Sprinkles. I've been eyeing up this place for so long. The main thing that I like, so certain sprinkle mixes you can kind of get everywhere. There are, usually they have their own knack, so a bit like Bake Box Boutique, they have a lot of neutrals, and the colour mixes that they have are very well put together. So the mix of colours work so well, and it's something that you wouldn't necessarily see elsewhere. They also have mixes which look very kind of general, like you could get them anywhere. And the main ones that stand out from Seriously Sprinkles is these first ones, and these are the ones that I really want. So they're solid colours, they're all the same colour, there's no mix of colours. This hot pink, absolutely gorgeous. The yellow, the turquoise, and then the normal pink are all lovely. So I think that they're really nice combos because it's a solid colour. You're not mixing colours, so it means that you can mix your own colours if you have multiple sprinkle bags, but you can also just use one solid colour. So I think they're really, really nice. Then there's a lot of Christmas ones. There's a solid gold mix, which again is lovely. And then this, I also saw this pink lemonade. Again, so nice. It's got hot pink and yellow, and it's so pretty. But those are the main ones that stand out for me. I quite like these. I've kind of got into it recently, but these mixes with the really big pearls in them. And I just like that they're all one solid colour. It's just very appetising. Then the next place is Cake Decorating Company. So I added a load of my favourite colours, which I thought were really nice colours for bakers, and I've also got a couple of sprinkle mixes on here because I love sprinkles. I just can't stop buying them. So we have, just going to zoom you in so you can see a bit better. So we've got mustard, and the thing with colour mill is it's really nice and pigmented whether you're going pastel or not, whereas there's certain companies, I sometimes find it a little bit with Pro Gel and Colour Splash, is if I want to go pastel, because the colour is dark, so say it's like navy, if I wanted to get a light blue, it's going to be the wrong tone because it's meant to be navy. Like, you're meant to add enough to make it navy. Whereas Colour Mill, you can add a little bit to make it pastel, and it still gives you a lovely tone without losing that colour. It will just be a lighter version of, say, mustard. Whereas sometimes I find with other brands, you lose that pigment. It just kind of turns into like a washed out colour rather than a nice like vibrant pastel. So I've been transitioning. I've got so much colour mill now. I used to have maybe like one or two, and now I've got about 15 of them. But I love these new colours. So mustard is a new colour. It's also in with rust, which again is a lovely colour. I already have dusk, which is very similar to rust, so that's why I didn't actually add it to my bag. Then we have peach, which is a gorgeous colour if you want a pastel orange. There's a photo I'll show you in the actual listing for the peach one, and this this is just lovely to me. So, where has it gone? This is the peach. See, it's this lovely pastel orange, like corally colour. Then, this cake is gorgeous. So, this is a mix of clay and latte, both of which are in my basket. Then we have bluebell, which is again a lovely, lovely colour. So let's see if they have some photos from this. So these aren't, bluebell is the lighter tone in here, I believe. Sea mist is the more vivid blue one. It's a bit more pastel than that. Then there is also, so we have mustard. I've already got rose, which is a really nice colour. Then I added, we already have latte. Where is it? Ocean midnight. So this colour scheme, I again think is lovely. So I already have the sage and the olive. They're really nice colours, but I really like the midnight and the bluebell. So again, I think they're definitely like staples for if you're looking for some new colour mill colours. More so if you don't know what you want. I think these are really nice colours and they're from the new range. And then also lemon was a really pretty colour. They don't have any photos of what it looks like on, but I've seen some other bakers using it. But that is again a really nice colour. And they're £5, which I think is reasonable considering they are very good colour tones. They have a wide range of colours. Whereas obviously certain other brands like Colour Splash, if you're going for pink, you have hot pink and baby pink, and that's pretty much it. Whereas this, they have so many tones. You can get blush, you can get rose, you can get baby pink, you can get raspberry, which is like a really hot pink, which I have and it's lovely. So there's just a lot more variety, I think. Then another place for sprinkles, this is more for mixes, which I love, is Happy Sprinkles. I have a couple of their mixes. So as you can see, look at how aesthetically pleasing that mix is. But if you don't use mixes a lot, so if you need a lot of different colours because you do a lot of different coloured cakes, then it's not as good. I find that you want a small amount of this. Don't get the 180 unless you're getting a single colour. I always get the 90 when I'm buying from Happy Sprinkles just because I won't necessarily use them that much because they are particular colour schemes. Then there is also this one, which is the cotton candy, which was the other one I had in my basket, which is again gorgeous, such vibrant colours. So I really like Happy Sprinkles. Then the other thing that I would recommend, there was also these large sprinkles, which Happy Sprinkles does, and they are large pearls. They're massive and they look really good on like cupcakes and also just on cakes. The other thing the Cake Decorating Co. sells, this would be more of like, I'd say maybe get a voucher. If someone wants to get you a voucher, then this is a good place. Because things like boxes, boards, colourings, anything like that, which is something that you buy regularly, you can buy it from here. If someone got you a voucher from here, it'd be quite good because then you'd get like a free month of boxes because you wouldn't have to buy any that month. So it's good in that sense. And then we have Amazon. So I've put a few, there's not crazy amounts in here. There was two books which I wanted to mention because I want them myself. And also one of them, I think both of them are on offer, but one of them more so. So we have the James Patisserie, can't speak today. Then we have the Finch Bakery. The Finch Bakery is usually £20, it's £11. That's why I thought I'd mention it. And I haven't got it. But again, I've heard rave reviews about it and I really feel like I should get it because all of the smaller treats I really want to try. So yes, we will see if that comes to fruition. But these recipe books are definitely a must. Then cooling racks is an essential item. I just put a few things which I feel like I use on a daily basis. That is these cooling racks because you can stack them. So they're great because you just stack up your cakes or your cupcakes. Really good. This acrylic rolling pin, I have a slightly different one because I bought it a while ago, but this one is very similar, and it's an acrylic one because I used to have a wooden one for so long and it would occasionally, like, eventually it splints and then you have to get a new one because it's where you wash it a lot. And then the other thing is it occasionally creates like wood marks where obviously it's wood, so it has like grooves in it because it's not solid. A bit like the acrylic is just solid and it's smooth. So this is a lot better, and also I found it didn't stick as much. It was a lot easier to just put some icing sugar on and it wouldn't stick at all, whereas again I found that it would stick more to the wooden. These are some tins that I got recently and I love these 8-inch tins. They're not PME, so they're not branded, but I thought that they were really good because I usually have thinner 8-inch tins, but that's becoming a problem because all of my layers are usually very thick, maybe like 2-3 inches, but my 8-inch were like maybe like 1.5 inches. They were really, really thin and it was really bothering me because obviously people just get more layers of cake. So it's not that they get less cake, but when you're baking it, it's a lot more hassle to do 6 layers than to do 4, because I can fit 4 in the oven, but I can't fit 6. So I would have to do 2 lots of baking rather than just putting them all in the oven, and I just wanted some deeper tins. So these are like 3 inches deep, so they're really good. And then we have the PME ones, which I bought. And if you have a bit more money, or like someone wants to spend a bit more money on you, then these are a good idea. That one's a set of 4 for £13. These are individuals and they are a bit expensive. So this is what I bought for my 6-inch and my 4-inch. So I bought 4 of each, and you can get 4-inch by 3-inch tall, then you can get 6-inch tins. I think they do in between as well. I think they do like 5, 7-inch, 9-inch, all of that. But I think they go all the way up to about 12 in PME, but obviously they get more expensive the higher you go. So this is £6 for the 4-inch. So they go up to, I think, about £7 for the 6-inch and so on and so on. So if you need 4 tins, which you most likely will, because most people doing tall cakes would need at least 3 tins, then it will be a little bit pricier. So it just depends if the person buying the gift has the budget for that. Then this is something that I want. I have something very similar, it just doesn't have the lines on it. And this is those non-stick rolling mats. So it's for fondant and dough and various other things. So this is one thing that I think would be really, really helpful. I wouldn't actually mind having one myself, even though I've already got mats. I had to pop out because I had spin, and I forgot to actually sign off on that. But we're going to get back into it. So that was the last thing for Amazon, was the non-stick mat. Now we've just got a few more bits, and that is literally just some nozzles from Finch Bakery. There's a couple that I really like. I've got 2 of theirs, and there's also some that I would just like to have. So as you can see, there are quite a few. So I really like the Lauren and the Emily. I have both of those. I really like the Leanne. I have one very similar, so I have the Wilton version, so it's very similar. And then also the, where is it? Is it at the top? I think it might be, no, that's the Mandy. The 1B is very similar to the 2D, the rose nozzle. And then the Rachel is like a smaller version. Oh, that is the 2D. And then the 1B is similar to the 1M, which is a Wilton nozzle. But I would definitely recommend the, where is it? Lost my place again. I definitely recommend the 1E because it is gorgeous. I use it all the time now. I use it like on most cakes. And then I feel like an honourable mention needs to be said for myself, obviously. I am still offering all of the merch. We have silicone moulds, scrunchies, resin coasters, and then we have the digital files as well, but they're not so much a gift that you can get literally. But yeah, we have tote bags, postcards, pretty much the finishing touches that you may need for your little gift list. So I'm hoping that that covered everything that you might necessarily want on a gift list. So that is going to be the end of day 7. I'm hoping that you found the gift guide helpful. I really, really like Bakebox Boutique and also Lizzie Lou. Love them both. So I would definitely recommend those two. And also they're good with posting. You can get things soon, so that means that we've only got, say, 2 weeks until Christmas, so you'll be able to get that stuff quickly. So I definitely recommend ordering from them. Seriously Sprinkles, I believe I've ordered their stuff on eBay, like where you order on eBay and then it turns out that it's them, but I've never ordered directly off their site. However, I've heard so many good things, so again, I definitely recommend them. But yeah, that is everything on the gift guide, so I hope you found that useful. Let me know if you've tried any of the things that I put on there already, because I mean, most of it I've either tried or know of. So yeah, let me know. But I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in tomorrow's video. Bye.